Hello viewers, this is your homeboy MC Bernardino. You're welcome to Canada Immigration with MC Bernardino, where I dish out information for those that want to migrate to Canada. So if this is your first time on this channel, take some few moments on this channel, click on the subscription button, there's a notification bell, click on it so that anytime I drop a video, you get notified. And if you're coming for the opt-in time, you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to this YouTube channel. All right, so before I go into today's episode, what I have for you today, I'll be doing a giveaway on this channel. It's Christmas period and it's a 1 year anniversary starting this YouTube channel. Just to encourage you guys, just to say thank you very much for your support, for being around for a long time, I will be doing a giveaway. So on December 1st, I'll be dropping a video on the modalities, procedure, how you can be a lucky winner on this YouTube channel. So guys, I'm going to stay tuned. December 1st, I'll be dropping a video. All right, let's go into the nitty-gritty today. What do I have for you today? I've received a lot of questions about the open work permit. How do I apply for spousal open work permit? So on this channel today, I'll be telling you, for those that are married, you want to bring in your spouse to Canada, how can you apply for spousal open work permit? That's what I'll be dishing for you today. The modalities, how you go about the requirements, everything, I'll be dissecting it for you today. So you want to hang on tight, stay tuned, call your friends, call everybody around you, share this video for your loved ones, those I think you will need it. Grab a cup of coffee because today's program is actually loaded.
Shall we begin? Let's begin now.
So just the background information about spousal open work permit. Spousal open work permit is an integral part of work permit generally in Canada. It is designed by IRS, Canada Immigration, to reunite spouse. Your partner is, you are here, your partner is outside Canada, just to reunite you. That's what this program is actually designed for. So who are those qualified to apply for spousal open work permit? One, if you are presently working in Canada in any job, not O, A, or B, you are qualified. So your job, occupation, your job role should be in either NOC OA or B for you to qualify. Anything short of that, NOC C or D, you're not entitled to spousal open work permit. And don't forget, in addition to that, you'll need to be approved. Your job, your work permit should be for a minimum of 6 months. Anything 6 months or longer, anything shorter than that, you are not qualified to apply for spousal open work permit. This information are verifiable from their website. Also, it's possible a spouse of a foreign student at a public secondary school, such as university, college, or college in Quebec, you are also qualified. So are you presently in Canada, you're studying in a college, in any of the post-secondary school, like college or university, also in Quebec, in any college in Quebec too, you are also qualified to apply for spousal open work permit. In addition to this, if you're a foreign military officer or a foreign representative, you are also entitled to, but I won't be talking about that. I'll solely be talking about, as a student and as a worker, you are qualified to apply for study for spousal open work permit. How do you go about it? What are the eligibility requirements? What are the procedures? I'll be telling you. I'm going to stay tuned. I'll be telling that eligibility criteria for all applicants, either you're a student or you're a worker. What are the eligibility criteria as stated by IRCC? First, you need to prove to the officer that you will leave Canada when your work permit expires. So your work permit, when you know it's you're on a temporary visa, right? So you need to be able to prove to the immigration officer that when your work permit expires, you and your spouse that is coming into Canada to join you, you guys will be leaving Canada when your work permit expires. You need to be able to prove that. How do you do that? I've done several videos on this. Just show several tiles to back home. So you need to be able to convince the immigration officer on that. Two, you need to show sufficient proof of fund. You're here in Canada, probably you're working or you're schooling, you want to bring in your spouse to come and join you need to show sufficient fund that you can take care of yourself and at the same time take care of the spouse. At the same time, your spouse too, wherever he or she is, should also have a significant amount of money in his or her bank account too, just to show sufficient proof of fund. Also, you need to show that you don't have any criminal record, and your spouse too. Sometimes your spouse might be required to go through some police clearance background, so that Canada wants to make sure that people that are coming into Canada are not of threat or danger to the Canada community. So that's why you need to do that too. And also, your spouse might be required to do medical too. You yourself coming into Canada, you must have done your medical, so your spouse too might be required to do the medical too. In addition to this, the officer also might require from some document, so additional document like marriage certificates, all might also be required for you to prove that you're actually in a relationship with your spouse. So these and lots more are what you need for you to be eligible to apply for Spousal open work permit. So now let me now talk about the two aspects. I mean, either as a student or as a worker, applying as a student or a worker. So first and first, let me talk about as a student. So if you're applying, that simply means that you yourself, you're in Canada studying and you want to apply for Spousal open work permit for your partner that he or she is back home. So what are the things you need? So the things you need as a student is that you need to, don't forget that you need to go online. I'll be linking the website where you can fill the form on the RLCC website to apply for Spousal open work permit. Fill the application form. In addition to that, you need to attach some supporting documents. Like one, you need to attach study permit. You know, don't forget that you have a study permit because presently studying in Canada. You need to attach a study permit. In addition to that, you need to attach enrollment letter from your school. I mean, you need to talk to your professor, talk to your dean in your school. They need to give you an enrollment letter. That simply states that you are presently enrolled full time and you're presently studying in Canada. That is very significant, guys. You need to put that in addition to document you're attaching. Because if the immigration officer doesn't see that, it might raise a red flag. So your study permit, your letter of enrollment that shows that you're presently enrolled. If you have your transcript in school, probably your first semester transcript, attached to it too. In addition to this, marriage certificates, you need to attach that too. I mean, something to show that you're actually married to your spouse. Attach that. Proof of fund, your bank statement for yourself here in Canada and your spouse also, wherever he or she is coming from. Your bank statement is also very paramount. These and lots more are what you need. I mean, try as much as possible to prove. Don't forget the titles you need to prove that you'll be going back when you're done. These are lots more what you need to show if you're applying for Spousal open work permit while you yourself you are presently studying in Canada. On the other side, let's talk about if you're presently working in Canada on a postgraduate work permit. Probably you finish your studying and you want to apply for you're presently working in Canada and you want to apply to bring in your spouse. You can also do that too. What are the documents required? So these are two things now. You are no more a student now, you're not working in Canada. So what are the requirements? What do you need to apply for to bring in your spouse? Now, first and first, you need your letter of employment. So talk to your employer. They need to give you a letter of employment that states the job position that you have. Don't forget I said that the job position needs to be in either NOC O, A, or B. Anything short of that is not allowed. So your employer needs to give you a letter, a reference letter that states your position, how much you're earning, are you full-time? This needs to be in the letter. In addition to that, you need to attach your most recent pay stub, 2-3, as much as you can, pay stub to show that you're actually making money in Canada and you're actually working truly. So you need to attach your pay stub in addition to that. Your marriage certificate, like I said, for this as a student, also need it as a worker too. Proof of fund too. I mean, you're working, you need to show substantial proof of fund. Your spouse too needs to show that. Don't forget, I've told you about the medical, the police grants for your spouse. Back home, it needs to also be shown too. So these and lots more are what you need when you're applying for Spousal open work permit. Guys, this is not limited, guys. What I've just told you is not exclusive. If you need additional information, feel free to go to the RLCC website, the immigration website. There are tons and tons of information there. Even what I'm telling you guys today, I got them from Canada immigration website. So you won't get it wrong if you also go online to do your own additional research. Guys, don't forget, I always put in the disclaimer that I'm not an immigration officer. I just try to give information. You can also get online too if you go and research it. How much? What's the cost for applying for Spousal open work permit? As of the last time I checked online, it's $255 Canadian for you to apply. I mean, you can pay through your credit card, money order, a lot of options for you to pay. In addition to this, what's the processing time? I know you might want to ask me, how long does it take? What's the duration? I can't tell you categorically how long it takes. But even if you go online, they will never state how long it takes. It depends on the country you are applying from. I mean, it could range from a minimum of 5 weeks to as much as 20 weeks. It depends on the country your spouse is. I mean, that depends on, because don't forget that the application, whatever your application, whether you're submitting it online or paper, it still needs to go through your local, your country visa office, Canada visa office. So that's why it takes longer time depending on the country you're applying for. So what I'm just going to advise you is that don't delay. You can actually do it now. If it's worth doing, it's worth doing well. And also, please note something that Canada immigration generally, they try as much as possible to reunite family. They take pride in uniting family. So if they can do anything for you. What you can do for yourself is to apply for your spousal. I mean, there's no need to delay on that. I'll give you a case study. The way I brought my wife to Canada was through spousal open work permit. While I was studying, I actually brought my wife through spousal open work permit, and it actually works. All you need to do is get the documentation right, do due diligence, verify your information very well, submit everything you need to submit, make the payment, and if there's no need to doubt your application, you are good to go. So why waste time? Why delay? Just go for the application. Something I need to quickly touch on is this. Some people might want to ask me, because I think I received this question from one of my viewers that said, oh, he or she got a study permit and he or she is still, outside Canada. He got the study permit and he wants to know if he should immediately apply for the wife to while outside Canada. So what I can tell you, what I advise him then was that you should not apply for your spouse right away. What you need to do is come into Canada, start your program, because don't forget that one of the criteria I told you was that as a student, if you're applying for your spouse to join you, you need to show that you're presently in school, you need to show your transcript, your enrollment letter from your dean, from your department, that needs to be proved too. So you need to come into Canada, start your study, one month rather, as case may be, you can apply, then apply for spousal open work permit. I mean, do the documentation right, you won't get it wrong. So if you feel you have any question, anything you're concerned about, please feel free to drop it in the comment section below. I try as much as possible to answer your question. And feel free to also go online to do your own additional research. I'll be linking the website on how you can apply for your spousal open work permit in this video down below, guys. All right, if you feel you enjoyed this video, again, hit the likes button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to this channel and share this video with your loved ones too. I'll be coming back to you guys with the Think About This segment, where I always drop the punchline, you ponder on it, you think about it, and it helps to make your day. All right, people, so on the Think About This segment, I stumbled on this wonderful quote by Napoleon Hill, and he said, if you cannot do great things, do small things in a great way. Once again, if you cannot do great things, do small things in a great way. This is actually very motivational, and I decided to share this with you. I mean, you don't really have to wait to do the big thing. I mean, you can actually do a little thing in a great way. So how this is applicable is this: if you want to apply for your spousal open work permit, you don't have to really wait for you to have big huge money or for everything to be rosy before you apply. Do it in a small way. All you have to do is getting it right. So guys, you don't have to wait. Do small thing in a big way, and everything will go on fine with you. All right, guys, this is where I'll be drawing the curtain on today's episode of Canada Immigration with MC Bernardino. I've spoken to you about spousal open work permit. I mean, don't delay. If you feel you have the qualification, you have all the documents, do it right away. Reunite your family, reunite your spouse, bring your spouse to join you in Canada, and you guys will be reunited once again. Don't forget, on December 1st, I'll be dropping a video, giveaway video, on how you go about the procedure. Wait for it December 1st. In 2 days' time, I'll be dropping the video, guys. Till I come back to you guys with another informative, scintillating, educative video on Canada Immigration with MC Bernardino. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to this channel. Thank you.